impeachment proceedings to embark on those two bills so that the coffee farmers can realize the full benefit of the coffee reforms that we have initiated. There is another allegation that I have taken control of a local cooperative society in Madeira constituency. I don't know the name of that constituency, of that cooperative. It is false. I am yet to see any evidence. I have nothing to say because there is nothing to be said. On the issue of shareholding, which I think members are interested in listening to, I listened to you this morning, and it was quite emotive. By virtue of provisions of the third schedule of the Political Parties Act, the constituent parties of the Kenya Kwanza Coalition entered into various agreements, which were deposited with the Speaker of the National Assembly and the Speaker of the Senate for purposes of Article 108 of the Constitution of Kenya. The following were members: UDA, ANC, Ford Kenya, PA, Farmers Party, Chama cha Kazi, Communist Party, Economic Freedom Party, Service Party, Tujibebe wa Kenya Party, Umoja na Maendeleo Party of Kenya, and the Democratic Party of Kenya. In accordance with the provision of Clause 3, Schedule 3, a power-sharing agreement and development agenda for the certain regions of Kenya, I attach copies of these agreements, RG32. All those agreements talked about specific regions. The leaders who appended their signatures canvassed issues of appointments to do with specific regions. Power sharing agreement between UDA and ANC and Ford Kenya, for example, say that the UDA would nominate the coalition president, the presidential and deputy presidential candidates that was honored. The president would agree, would guarantee the stature, the dignity, and financial and operational autonomy of the office of the deputy president, which I've been insisting on because it's part of the coalition agreement. The ANC would be allocated the position of the prime cabinet secretary, which has happened. Ford Kenya would be allocated the position of the Speaker of the National Assembly, and that is why Honorable Masika Wetangula sits here today. In accordance with Article 2 of the Power Sharing Agreement, ANC and Ford Kenya would have a 30% share, share is a word, of the national government positions. This drives my utterances about shareholding. It is embedded in all these agreements that are attached here for you to read. I heard this morning an honorable member saying that the deputy president said the people of Ukambani will not get resources because they did not vote for Kenya Kwanza government. That is not true. The deputy president of the Republic of Kenya does not allocate resources. Resources for the development of the Republic of Kenya are appropriated by the National Assembly of Kenya, where I am today. The deputy president will help the president to oversee the implementation of funds allocated and appropriated by the National Assembly. It is therefore not possible that the deputy president of the Republic of Kenya has the capacity to deny any part of Kenya resources because of the way they voted. The decisions on how resources will be allocated for the development of the Republic of Kenya are made here by the honorable members. If your area has no development, please don't impeach the deputy president. Don't accuse him of not giving you resources. You are in this house to make sure that your area where you come from is allocated appropriate resources, because that is your job. The agreements are attached, therefore I don't want to go into them. Let me say my speeches on the shareholder issue were informed by the voisin power sharing covenants, which are founded on law, having been deposited with the Registrar of Political Parties, and lessons learned from the well-known disputed 202 NAC power sharing agreement. Further, sharing agreements are a feature of government formation in all democracies in the world that provide for the formation. My pronouncements on the issue, properly understood, are not only anchored in law, but entirely harmless and incapable of creating, of being construed as a basis for ethnic animosity, a danger to national cohesion, or a threat to national unity. On the contrary, coalition building has been one of the most important innovations since the disputed 2007 elections in ensuring stability, equitable sharing of political power, national cohesion, and fostering of national unity. Indeed, Kenya Kwanza's main opponent in 2022 general election, Azimio la Umoja Coalition, One Kenya Coalition Party, was a political party consisting of 25 or political parties who also executed a power sharing agreement based on shares. I'm also aware that the Jubilee Coalition that executed a 50-50 power sharing agreement between TNA Party and URP Party for 2013 general election. I have thus not violated Section 13(1)(a) and 62 of the National Cohesion Integration, nor has this commission summoned me to explain any of my comments and how it can affect cohesion. However, notwithstanding the said power share agreement, upon election as Deputy President, I went out of my way, as required by the Constitution of Kenya, to serve all Kenyans regardless of their political preferences during the election or ethnic origin. I now produce the following video showing some of my speeches all over the country as marked RG Video 7.
We want to confirm to the people of Nyanza that the Ruto administration will serve all Kenyans, those who elected us and those who did not. Kenya hii kila mtu afanyiwe kazi. Kwa sababu kila mtu analipa kodi.
Mimi si kusema Kenya ni ashia mbaya. Nisema serikali, kiumbe serikali. Wale wanakusaidia kuhusu. Unatakiwa uweke wengi wale walikuwa. Nasema nilikuwa Mombasa ya bana mlima mimi nilikuwa Wajia ya bana mlima nilikuwa Garissa hii ya bana mlima nilikuwa Mount Elgon Nandi nimekuja karibu mara 10 Eldoret nimekuja karibu mara 6 Kericho nimekuja mara 4 tea conference ya chai tulikuwa na nyinyi nilikuwa Kericho
for now kazi yetu ni maendeleo tutafanya kazi na kiongozi wote akuwa wa chama ile akuwa wa chama hii we don't care this is the time
Mr. Speaker, copies of documents demonstrating my efforts within the mandate allocated to me by the President to address security issues and economic equalization programs and policy in historically marginalized areas is annexed RG33. The decision to embrace the broad-based government following the dissolution of cabinet after the Gen Z protest. I attached my video during the launch of the Honorable Raila Odinga's quest for EU chairmanship at State House, again as a demonstration of my embracing the broad-based government.
Your Excellency, Dr. William Ruto, President of the Republic of Kenya and Commander-in-Chief of the Defense Forces, Your Excellencies, Heads of States and Government present, Your Excellencies, Ambassadors and High Commissioners and members of the Diplomatic Corps, Heads of Delegations, Members of Parliament and all dignitaries present, good morning. Your Excellency, let me say, this is a great moment for our country. What a day, what a moment. We are here, Your Excellency, as a country to unveil Kenya's finest to go and lead Africa. It's a proud moment for this country. And I want to say, Your Excellency, the people of Kenya have been united to a man by the candidature of the Right Honorable Raila Odinga to be the chairperson of the African Union Commission. This is a quest that has brought pride to our nation. And I would like to tell the leaders here from Africa and the representatives that as a country, as we present the Honorable Raila Odinga to be our candidate, it is because Africa, our motherland, deserves the best. The passion and zeal of the Right Honorable Raila Odinga in Pan-Africanism is well documented. Passion knows no age, knows no limit. In the person of the Right Honorable Raila Odinga, he joined the ranks of Jomo Kenyatta and Kwame Nkrumah in pushing the agenda for Africa. I therefore want to say, Your Excellency, the lessons of today are that Raila Odinga, the Right Honorable, is a man of great resilience, endurance, and perseverance. Today, you are going to unveil the transformation of the Right Honorable Odinga from a national leader to an African statesman. And for all us in leadership, we have learned great lessons of resilience, endurance, and perseverance. Somebody may ask, why is Rigathi Gachagua, who has before had issues with the leadership of Raila Odinga? As a truthful man, I have nothing against him. It's only that we are competing for the same position between him and my boss. Now that he is going for a bigger seat in Africa, all of us, from the president, I, and the rest of Kenya, are behind him. And the Right Honorable Raila Odinga, as a man who listens to the ground, let me confirm to you, I've listened to the ground, and all Kenyans across the political divide, across communities, are in support of your candidature, and we wish you well. Before I call Your Excellency, let me acknowledge the place of family, not just in our lives, but in leadership. I think it is a great moment for the Right Honorable Raila Odinga. It's appropriate that I acknowledge on behalf of the country the role Mama Ida Odinga has played in the life of this great son of this land. Mama Ida Odinga, we salute you as a country for having been a very strong pillar to your husband in very difficult times, and his lowest moments, you have always been there for him. We ask families to support their spouses. So Mama Ida Odinga, as we wish you happy birthday, it is my hope and prayer that your next birthday will be celebrated at Addis next year. And if you invite President William Ruto to come and he's not able to come, Mr. President, I'll be very happy for you to send me to represent you in that great basket. We therefore want to say, as a country, this is a great moment. And the Right Honorable Odinga, I have noted with a lot of appreciation, my wife, Pastor Dorcas, who is a very prayerful woman, has been praying for me and the President daily. And I noted from yesterday she has added you in her prayer. And because her prayers work, we have no doubt that you will get this seat. Mr. President, it is now my honor to request you to come and anchor Kenya's finest and embark on the journey of transformation of the Right Honorable Raila Odinga from a national leader to a great African statesman.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. President William Ruto has many times appreciated my people issues and has repeatedly pronounced himself. Let me have the video number 9.
And speaking of deputies, you have in the last few weeks named Mr. Rigathi Gachagua as your deputy. There's been quite a debate, and I'm sure you know that, around running mates in this country. Perhaps this would be a great time to shed light on why you settled on this gentleman.
Rigathi Gachagua is somebody I have known. Rigathi Gachagua is a very passionate leader. Rigathi Gachagua is a people's person. He speaks about the things that I speak about. He speaks about ordinary people. He's concerned about matters to do with farmers. He's concerned about the things that are dear to ordinary Kenyans. And the nexus between me and Rigathi Gachagua is the people. He believes in bottom up the way I do. And that is why I chose Rigathi Gachagua to work with me.
Thank you very much.
Speaking of deputies.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. In addition, and almost in conclusion, I am not the only leader at the national level who has encouraged unity among Kenyans based on shared regional, geographical, and economic and other factors. I have attached several articles. Luya unity is not optional, versus Wetangula. Ruto puts case for Gema College in unity. Bijikenda unity in the offing. Masai leaders in unity talks ahead of next year's general election. I have attached those articles so that you understand that regions uniting does not mean they unite again in other regions.